Dear student, in last video we discussed concept of ER data model. In ER data model we discussed the two main component. One is entity, second one is the attribute. Entity, let me say that object, events, that is used to store the values and the user environment or anything about which organization want to maintain the data. Attribute, the properties are characteristics of the entity. Now today we will discuss concept of the relationship. What is the relationship? A relationship is a meaningful association among the different entity type. When we are having the different entity types are there, like student entity type, course entity types, teacher entity type, student entity type. So, meaningful association among the different entity type, that is called relationship. Or simply we say that a relationship is the association among the instance of one or more entity type. Let we say that we are having one entity type is your student, second one entity type is your course. So, association among the student and course, that is student complete course, students enroll in course. If we are having entity type is teacher, second entity type course, teacher teach course. If we are having teacher and student, teacher teach student. So we are having the meaningful association among the instance of one or more entity type. That meaningful association is called relationship. Relationships are the glue that hold the different component of ER model. Whenever we have different component of ER model, relationship hold together the different component of ER models. So to hold the different component together, we are having the concept of relationship. Next one, we are having the graphical representation, how we can graphically represent relationship. Can be represented graphically by line labeled with the name of relationship. So here if we checked, complete is a relationship. We are having the lines between the two different entity types. That is used to show the associations or relationship among the entity types. And we are having not only lines, labeled lines, right? Label lines with the name of the relationship. Here the name of the relationship is complete. So students complete courses. Complete is a relationship. If we checked, here we are having the student entity type is there, course entity types is there. In student entity types, we are having the different attributes are there. We are having are a properties of the student entity types that are roll number, name and birth date. Here course, course ID, course title and topic. If we check it over here, roll number, that is underlined, so that is the identifier. Similarly, if we checked over here course ID, this one is also identifier. Now here topic is enclosed in the curly braces. It means that is a multi-value attribute that may contain more than one value. And the relationship we are having the that is denoted by line labeled with the name of relationship. So here line labeled with the name of relationship completes. This one is the cross-footed notation. If we see that we are having the chain notation, and chain notations we have to use the diamond symbols for the name of the relationships. Let we are having the imply entity is here. In imply entity we are having the different attributes are there, roll number, that is the identifier, why we are using it underline, name, this one is we are having the composite attributes that can be decomposed into meaningful component, first name, middle name and last name. Then we are having the date of birth, single attribute. Now another if we check second one entity, we are having the course, and course ID, title and topic are there, and then we are having the relationship is here, that is denoted by diamond symbols between these two entity, course and employee. So employee complete course, so this one is a relationship, and chain notation we have to use the diamond symbols for the relationship, while in cross-footed notations we are using labeled line with the name of relation, line with the name of the relationship. Now we are having the relationship instance, association between entity instance, which include one occurrence from each participating entity type. So here we are having the entity instance are there. We are having chain is the entity instance, Melton is the entity instance. Here in the course entity, we are having instance is here C++. Another instance that is a Java. So associations between the entity instance. Here we are having associations chain and C++, chain and Java, chain and Visual Basics. That is the association between the entity instance, which include one occurrence from each participating entity type. So here one occurrence is chain, and second one participating entity type is here course. From the course participating entity type, we are having the C++. So each line represents a relationship instance between one employee and one course. Or we say that it includes the one occurrence from each participating entity type. That is called relationship instance. Next, it is possible the attribute that may be associated with the relationship. Here we are having the relationship is here, completes is a relationship. So with this one, completes relationship, one attribute is associated with the relationship, and that one attribute is a dead complete. Each instance of the relationship completes, there is a value for the dead completes. Let's take another example. If we checked over here in chain notation, teachers teach courses. Teachers attributes are their staff names and names, staff numbers and names, course ID and title. Teacher teach courses. Now here it teach times and teach durations. Now these are the attributes that we may not be able to associate either with the teacher or course. So whenever we are having such attribute that we may not be able to associate with any of the participating entity types, we can't associate teach times. Let we are having teacher is here ID 1. Let me draw it over here. We are having that I'm using the word have a staff number. And name. Teacher 1, name is here Bilal. Right now here if you want to use it over at teach times, how many times, what is the starting times, let me set it 130 or 120 p.m. If same teacher is teaching another course, another second one time is here, let me set it 3 p.m. Now we may not be able to store this one value in the when this one teacher teach this, so we may not be able to store teach times or teach durations. Here teacher is teaching for the 1 hour, here teacher is teaching for the th- 3 hours. So it's meant that we may not be able to associate teach times and teach duration with the teacher entity. Now same, if we want to use it the same for the course, that we are having course ID, course title and teach times. Course ID 1, title, we see that in for the course, course ID, I am using just CID. And then we are having the database. And we are having the, course ID. And then we have the, then we have course ID, title, if we want to, course ID is we are having one, title is there DB. If we want to use it over here, teach time, so teach time, let me set at 120, second teacher, another teacher is teaching the courses at 11 a.m. Third one is teaching at 9 a.m. So we may not be able to store the value of the teach time. One is teaching the subject of the database for the 2 hours, second is teaching for the 1 hour. So we may not be able to associate these attributes with any of the participating entity types. Whenever we are in such situation that we may not be able to associate the attribute with any of the participating entity types, and these attributes, each instance of the relationship, there is a value for the attribute on the relationship. So for each instance of the relationships, there is a value for this one. Let me say teacher teach any course for teacher teach data structures at 10 a.m. for the 2 hours. So when we say each instance of the relationship teach, there is a value of the teach time and teach duration. So teach time and teach duration, these are the attributes that we may not be able to associate with any of the participating entity types. Then we have to use these attributes with the relationship. Now next one concept, that is the associative entity type. The entity type, what is the associative entity types? The entity types that associate the instance of one or more entity types. Entity type that is associate the instance of one or more entity type and contain the attribute that belong to the relationships. Let here we are having entity types imply. Second one entity type, we are having the course. So when we see the entity type that associate the instance of one or more entity types, so here certificate is the entity types that associate the instance of employee and the course and contains attributes that belong to the relationships. If we previously checked, we are having the complete was the name of the relationship. So that complete was the attribute on the relationship. Now we say that the attribute that belong to the relationships become the attribute of the associative entity type. Whenever we are having entity type is available that is used to associate the instance of one or more than one entity type and containing attribute that belong to the relationships. So that is called associative entity type. Now here we are not using. And when we say that we are having associative entity types, in associative entity types, no relationship names is mentioned. Why? This one is also certificate. Associative entity type, this one is actually a relationship that associates the instance of two different entity types, employee and course. Associative entity type is like a relationship with an attribute, but it is also considered to be an entity type. Now, when should a relationship with the attribute instead by an associative entity. We are having the different conditions. Associative entity type exists only when all the participating entity types have many relationships. If we are having the relationship between the participating entity type is many to many. Many to many relationship is, let me say that one employee, each employee enroll in many course. For each course, we are having the many employee. We are having each employee, we are having the many course. Each employee complete many course. And each course is completed by the many employee. We are having the many to many relationship. Whenever we have the many to many relationships, then we have to use the concept of the associative entity types. Associative entity types have meanings independent of the other entities. This one can be exist independently. Associative entity type has its own identifiers and other attributes. It is possible that we may have the identifier of the associative entity. What is that? Here we see that certificate number is identifier of associative entity type and having other attributes that complete. This one is a independent entity. So what are the conditions? We say that whenever we are having many to many relationship among the entity types, then we have to use the associative entity types. Whenever we are having the relationships and attribute on the relationships, then we have to use the concept of the associative entity type. Simply we define it, entity type that associate the instance of one or more entity type and contain attribute that belong to the relationship. Now in chain notation, we are having how we can represent it. If we check it over here, associative entity types, normal entity type is represented by the rectangles, while associative entity types in the crossfitted notation, that is represented by the rectangle, rounded edge triangle, rectangles. So we are having the rounded edges rectangle is used for the associative entity types. While in the chain notations, we are having the diamond symbols is here, and that will be enclosed within the box or rectangles. So we say that diamond symbol enclosed in rectangles. Certificate is a associative entity type that is placed in the diamond symbol and that is enclosed by a rectangle. And here attribute are associated with this certificate entity, that are certificate numbers and that complete. Now next one is a degree of relationship. Degree of relationship, the number of entity type that participate in a relationship. Number of entity type participate in a relationship is called degree of relationship. That we are having the most commonly, we are in ER model, we are having the unary, binary and tertiary relationship. When we see that we are having the unary relationship, the relationship among the instance of single entity types, only one entity type is participating in a relationship, and that is called recursive relationship. It means that relationship with itself, only one entity type participating in a relationship. Relationship among the instance of a single entity type and the relationship among the instance of the same entity type, relationship with itself, that is called recursive relationships. That we are taking the example, we say that employee manage other employees. So we are having the relationship among the instance of same entity. Entity type is their employee, employee manage the other employee. That is relationship with itself. So this one is a unary relationship among the instance of the single entity types. Let another example, We are having so one entry type is here course. The name of entry type must be uppercase letter. Each course have many prereq courses. Each row course have n number of prereq. Prerequisite courses, right? So prereq is a relationship, right? Now here we are having unit relationship with the instance of the single entry types. So entry type is here course. That we are having the course, we are having the course of the data structures. For that one, programming fundamental is the prereq course. For the database, we say that programming fundamental is a prereq. For data warehousing, we say that database is a prereq course. For data mining, we say database and data mining are the prereq courses. So we are having the relationship among the instance of the single entry types. That is called unary relationship. And we are having the relationship itself. Here we are having only one entry type is participating in our relationship. So we are having relationship with itself among the instance of the same entry types. So that is called unary relationship. Now next one, we are having the binary relationship among the instance of two entity type, that is called binary relationship. Let me erase this one. Let we are having entry one, first one entity type is here employee. Each employee having one and only one parking space. One parking space is for one and only one employee. So we are having two different entity types such as data participating in a relationship. Relationship among the instance of the two entity types. Whenever we are having the relationship among the instance of the two entity types, that is called binary relationship. Another example, let student and department. We see that each department have n number of students and one student belong to one and only one department. I will explain these symbol cardinality constraints. Let's run. So each department, one department have n number of the students, one student is enrolled in one and only one department. So here relationship among the instance of the two entity type department and student, that is called binary relationships. Another example, student and course. Student enrolls in many courses. Each course we are having any number of the students. Relationship exists between the instance of the two entry type, that is called binary relationship. Now next one, we are having the tertiary relationship. Relationship among the instance of the three entry type, that is called tertiary relationship. Like we are having here vendor, warehouse and port. Vendor, warehouse supplies port to vendors. Yeah, vendor supplies port for the warehouse. So here we are having the attribute on the relationship. Relationship can have attributes. Another, let we are taking another example. Let we are having one is one entry type is here doctor. Having its other attribute like doctor ID, doctor names, doctor's address, qualifications, what else? Next one, we are having the patient. Patient have attributes And third one, entry type is here. We say that drug, medicines. Three different entry types are available. Drug ID, drug names, and I'm sorry for the doctor prescribed drug. Doctor, the name of relationship is here, prescribed. Doctor prescribes drug for patient. So three different entity types are participating in a relationship. Whenever three different entity types participate in a relationship, that relationship is called tertiary relationship. Now whenever we are having tertiary relationship, that is a good approach to use the associative entity type. So for the associative entity types, we say whenever we are having man-to-many relationship, then use the associative entity type. If we are having attribute on the relationship, use the associative entity type. And third one, whenever we are having the tertiary relationship, then good approach to use the tertiary relationship. So to use the associative entity type. So whenever we are having here entry types, we are having the three different entity types are participating in the same relationship, then we have to use it over here, the associative entity type. Let me see, there's another entry types, rounded corners rectangle, and that is a prescriptions that will be used as a associative entity type. This one is our independent entity type that may have prescriptions ID or invoice ID, what else, bill ID, anyone with names can be used, that can be used as identifier. It may have the its own attribute that we are having the prescription date. We may have the dose. So what else different attribute can be there? Whenever we are having three different entity types participate in a relationship, then we have to use the that relationship is called ternary relationship. And good approach to convert all the ternary relationship into associative entity. Here another vendor part and supplier, then supply scheduled is associative entity type that is a rounded corner and having its own attribute, that is a shipping mode and the unit cost. Then again, line labels are not used for the associative entity types. We already discussed this one. Now we are having the concept of the structure constraints. What is the structure constraint? The constraint placed on the entity type that participate in a relationship. Whenever we are having the different entity types that are participating in a relationship, we have to place some constraint, some set of rules. The main type of the constraints on the relationship is a multiplicity. What is a multiplicity? We see that single occurrence of entry types may relate to the possible occurrence of an associative entry type through a particular relationship. Now here we say we are having single occurrence of entry type. We are having entry types here, staff. Single occurrence of the staff entry types that may relate to the possible occurrence of an associative entry type. So associative entry type is here branch. Each stop manage possible occurrence of the participating entity type. That is called multiplicity. So in multiplicity, we are having the different type of the multiplicity. We are having one to many or many to many. These are the multiplicity. One to one relationship, one to many relationship, or many to many relationship. These are the multiplicity. Relationships, when we see that one to one relationships, how we say that? We see that each staff manage zero or one branch, and each branch is managed by one and only one staff member. I will explain one and zero, these symbols, in the cardinality, next one, constant. So here we say that in multiplicity, each instance of entity type staff, there exists a single instance of entity type branch that is called one-to-one relationship. Or simply, each instance of entity type A, there exists a single instance of entity type B. We are having the one-to-one relationships. Now, one-to-one relationships that we are having the staff is here. We say that each instance of entity type A, here entity type staff number S1, there exists a single instance of entity type B, that is a branch. Each instance of staff, there exists only one instance of entity type B, then we say that is a one-to-one relationship. Staff manage branch. One staff S1 only manage the staff B1. S3 manage the branch B2. S2 is not managing. That is a one-to-one relationship. Now, next one we are having is the one-to-many relationship. If for each instance of entity type A, there exists a many instance of entity type B. Each instance of entity type A, there exists a many instance of entity type B. We are having for each patient, there exists a many patient history. One or many patient history. That we are having Mark having only one patient history. This one is having the two different patient history. So how we can represent it? To represent one to many relationship, we have to write one to many relationship or one colon asterisk, that is used for the one to many relationships. So each patient having the many patient history. Patient has recorded many patient history. Each department, let another, we are taking an example. We are having the one is department and student. We say that we are having the department that is a one to many. And student. We can use the abbreviation for the name of entity type. Each department. What you see? For each instance of entity type department, there exists a many instance of entity type student. Relationship is here one to many. One department is here CS. Student name is here Ali. Student name is here Ahmed. So for each instance of the entity type A, there exists a many instance of entity type B. That is called one to many relationship. But here we may not have, for each student is there, there exists only one instance of the department. each student is enrolled in one and only one department. That is called one to many relationship. And next one, multiplicity type, that is a that we are having each departments. D1 has student S1, S2, S3 and S3. D2 has S4. But that is a one to many relationship. S1 belong to D1, S2 belongs to D1, S3 belong to D1. That is a one to many relationship. Each instance of entity type A, there exist many instances of entity type B. Now we are having many to many relationship. We have to write it over here, many to many or steric current steric. What we see, if for each instance of entity type A, there exist many instances of entity type B, and for each instance of entity type B, there exist many instances of entity type A. Simply we say, for each instance of entity type A, there exist many instances of entity type B, and vice versa. So that can be represented by many to many relationship. Like each student is registered in many courses. Each student Ali, that can be enrolled in the database, that can be enrolled in the data structure, that can be enrolled in the web. While in one subject database, we may have different students or chairs. So for each instance of entity type student, there exist a many instance of entity type course, and also vice versa. Each instance of the course, we are having the many instance of the entity type student. That is a many to many relationship. That we say student is here, for each student S1 is enrolled with the course C1 and C2. Then we are having S2 is enrolled with the course C3, while in C3 course, this one is a course C3, we are having the main student out there. For each instance of entity type B, there exist many instances of entity type A. Reverse is also here. So that is called many to many relationship. We can use it over here to represent it steric colon steric or M to M for the many to many relationship. And whenever we are having many to many relationship, we have to use the associative entity. Now we are having another type of the constraints. First one was the multiplicity. Second one is cardinality constraints. What is a cardinality constraint? We say that number of the instance of an entity type that can be associated with the each instance of another entity type is called cardinality constraint. That we see that each student is here. Each student complete one or many courses. But each course is completed by zero or many students. The number of instance of entity type that can be associated with the each instance of another entity type is called cardinality constraints. So each student complete one or more than one courses, but for each course there may or may not exist student who complete the course. Now when we see that we are having the cardinality as there, we are having the two different type of the cardinality, minimum cardinality and maximum cardinality. If the minimum cardinality that can be minimum number of the instance of entity type B that may be associated with the each instance of entity type A. And here we are having entity type B and A. Here course is the B and employee is the A. Minimum number of instance of entity type B that may associate with the each instance of the entity type A. That is called minimum cardinality. Minimum number of instance, here if we check, minimum number of the instance of the entity type B are the 0. When we are using here 0, it means minimum number of the instance of entity type B are 0. So minimum cardinality is optional. Right? If we are having minimum number of instance of entity type B are 0, then minimum cardinality is, we say that participation of that one entity type is optional. Reverse, if we say each product is assigned to one or many employee. So here minimum cardinalities, what do we say? Minimum number of instance of an entity type that may be associated with the each instance of entity type, another entity type. For each product, we are having one or many employee. So minimum cardinality is 1. Whenever we are having the minimum cardinality is 1, it's mean participation of this one entity type is mandatory. Employee participation is mandatory. But over here, for each employee we are having the 0 or many project. So when we say for each employee we have a 0 or many project. So what we have? 0. Minimum cardinality is 0. Minimum cardinality that can be 0 or 1. Minimum number of instance that may be associated with each instance of entity type A, that is called minimum cardinality. So minimum cardinality that can be either 0 or 1. If we have a minimum cardinality is 0, then participation of that one entity type is optional. If we are having the minimum cardinality is 1, then participation of that one entity type is mandatory. The minimum number of instances of entity type B are 0. When minimum number of instances of entity type is 0, participation is optional. Now, let me see. Each patient has one or many patient history. Minimum number of instance of entity type B that is associated with the each instance of entity type A. Each patient have one or many patient history. So here minimum cardinality is 1. Whenever minimum cardinality is 1, participation of this one entity type is mandatory. Now this one is related to the minimum cardinality. Next one we are having the maximum cardinality. Maximum number of instance. Minimum cardinality can be either 0 or 1. We say that if we are having minimum cardinality is 0, that is optional. If we are having minimum cardinality is 1, that is mandatory. Maximum number of instance of entity type B that may be associated with the each instance of entity type A. So maximum cardinality can be either 1 or many. First we say minimum cardinality can be 0 or 1. Maximum cardinality can be either 1 or many. So here each employee, we are having 0 or many project. For the many, we are using this one symbol. This symbol is used in the crossfoot notation that is used to represent the many. If we are using the 0 over here, it's mean this one is a optional. Minimum cut, this one is represent the minimum cardinality. This one is a minimum. Why this one is called, also this one is called minimum cardinality, while this is called maximum cardinality. Maximum instance of entity type B that may associate with the each instance of entity type A. Each employee have many projects. What maximum cardinality is here? Many. each imply may have zero or many projects. It may be possible that we are having imply having the no projects. It may be possible that we are having the imply having the many projects. So minimum cardinality is here zero. Whenever minimum cardinality is here zero, then participation of this one entry type is optional. Here minimum cardinality is here one, so participation of this one entry type is mandatory. Maximum number of instances of entry types are unspecified but many, and that is greater than 1. If we check the previous examples over here in this one examples, if we check minimum cardinality is here in this one, we see that minimum cardinality is 1, maximum cardinality is many. Here minimum cardinality is 1 and maximum cardinality is also 1. Over there maximum minimum cardinality we are having the 0, and maximum cardinality we are having the many. Here we are having the minimum cardinality 1, maximum cardinality we are having the many. It's about the different constraints that we have to implement on the relationship. It's all about the ER diagram. In the next video we will discuss how what are the case study, and also we will discuss the concept of the problem with ER models. Thanks for watching the video.